Last year, a family friend passed away from complications of diabetes at age 55. His wife afterwards discovered a whole pile of untaken medicine hidden in the corner of his bedroom. Then everyone finally realized why his diabetes had gotten worse so quickly. He had not been taking his medicine. Research shows that 50% of all people with a chronic disease, like diabetes, don't take their medication as prescribed. Medication non-compliance causes 200,000 deaths each year from the EU. There are various reasons for this, but the one major reason is a fear of side effects. Many diabetes medicines have severe side effects. That's also why scientists are constantly looking for better alternatives. I myself have been working with a group of active natural compounds extracted from the medicinal plant stevia. Some of these compounds are nicely sweet and have been used as food sweeteners. Maybe you know Coca-Cola stevia. But however, we found that at certain concentrations, these compounds also possess anti-diabetic effects. We know that diabetes is characterized by high blood sugar and insulin is a hormone that can reduce blood sugar. But here is a question. For diabetic patients, which one is worse, high blood sugar or low blood sugar? Surprisingly, low blood sugar is the most dangerous and common side effect of current diabetes medications. It may cause heart disease, nerve damage, or even death. When we tested stevia compounds, we used insulin-producing islets that we isolated from mouse pancreas. We made them into diabetes models and healthy models. Then we treated them with our compounds. The results? Well, in diabetes models, stevia compounds significantly increased insulin release, very effective. More importantly, in healthy models, stevia compounds had no detectable effects. This is actually fascinating because it indicates when healthy, when blood sugar is normal, even patients accidentally taking more stevia will not overstimulate insulin secretion, thereby preventing low blood sugar. So stevia compounds have the potential to prevent low blood sugar. It's still early stage of the research, but I believe this study will lead to a safe therapy for diabetic patients. Maybe we can even utilize their effects and sweetness together, then diabetic patients taking candy can finally be doctor recommended. Wouldn't that be sweet? Thank you.